Hello? Could I have a word?
If it isn't the former Archon unit mistress of torture herself.
You're still holding a grudge against me even now?
Didn't you go see the director?
She gave me a request. Larkbright Lagoon. The director is convincing the Senate to propose a truce with the Empire. She would like you to act as a messenger on the Senate's behalf.
Let's do it, Lark! If we can make it happen, then I think we should!
Yeah, we were headed for Diamant anyway.
I'm afraid I'll need you to visit the Senate beforehand. She's writing an official message as we speak. You'll have to go and pick it up.
Was this truce ordered by the Patriarch?
No. The Patriarch isn't involved in this.
Then isn't the Director's life in danger?
Well, they'll still never have a better chance than now. Uprisings are occurring in Empire-controlled areas. The Imperial Army is spread thin trying to suppress them. Anti-Imperial movements have been gaining momentum since the victory at Opalus.
It's true. The Empire might be open to a truce right now.
Weren't you supposed to be with Prince Alf, Leslie?
I was only with them to root out the QED while they were still after Adele. We've gone our separate ways now.
That's cold. I thought they were your friends.
I thought you were the one who said something about not knowing who your allies were, Serge. Anyway, let's go to the Senate.
Okay.
I've been here waiting for you, Mr. Lagoon.
Are you really going to form a truce with the Empire?
I hear that Empire-controlled regions are starting to rebel. Their numbers are increasing by the day. They're almost the size of an army now. They're calling themselves Alf's Army.
What?
So it's Alf pushing the rebellion, not the Republic.
It'd be fair to say that the Empire is tearing itself apart right now. They're spreading out their forces to deal with multiple simultaneous rebellions. The conditions are perfect for Emperor Mahat and his bloodthirsty son to sign a truce.
Can I ask you one question?
What is it?
Why a truce? Shouldn't you take this opportunity to strike back and reclaim your territory?
If the war drags on too long, both the Empire and the Republic will fall, won't they? Once the Code Disc investigation is over, that'll be the end of the Patriarch's Senate influence. We can't take an aggressive stance towards the Empire now.
All right. I promise I'll persuade Sir Vice to accept the truce.
Leslie will represent me. Good luck.
Phew. Finally.
Vice will be a tough nut to crack. Hope we can convince him.
I'll pound his twisted spirit into shape with my fists of justice!
If only it were that simple.
Lark?
Rithia, let me just say...
Hmm?
Don't pick sides for me, okay? I don't like to favor anyone.
That's why you're nice to everyone.
Hmm?
Never mind. I'm sorry.
Huh?
Huh? Where's Nico? Lark, look at this!
A letter from Nico?
Dear Mr. Lark, I've thought about it a lot, and I guess I'm not cut out to be a mercenary. If I stay with you, I'll only cause more problems. Truthfully, fighting is just too scary for me. So I've decided to leave. I'm sorry for everything.
Nico.
Let's look for him. Yeah!
No, don't.
Oh? Why not?
I don't want to force him into anything he doesn't want to do.
Are you sure?
I don't know, but I had a feeling it would come to this anyway.
I was so happy when you asked me to come back, Lark. I'm sure he'd be the same way.
I doubt that.
Looks like what happened in the Senate dungeon sure rang a bell with you, Lark. Let's leave him be. He's probably on his way back to Diamant anyway.
Hey, you're Larkbright Lagoon.
I'm escorting a messenger from the head senator in Termilia.
What? What should we do? Just wait right there. Don't move.
Ah, it's you. I wondered what all the ruckus was about.
My name is Leslie Ferrati. I am here on behalf of the head senator. May I please see the Emperor?
We want to stop the war between the Republic and the Empire. Please.
What should we do, General?
Apprehend them. Anyone who sides with the Republic is an enemy of the Empire.
Hey! What are you doing? We're here with a message of peace.
Guess the Empire's in no rush to end this thing, huh?
If the Emperor was alive, they'd at least allow messengers inside.
So you think the rumor's true?
Oh, it is.
General Freya.
Before long, Prince Vice will take the throne, and any chance we had at a treaty will be gone.
We might even be put to death.
Get out!
What are you doing?
The Imperial Army is in a precarious situation. Sir Alf's faction is colluding with the Republic to disrupt things from the inside. We can't expand the front. Besides, Sir Vice has no intention of talking with the Republic.
So why did you let us go?
Just remember that this is all I can do for you. If you get caught by any watchmen, I can't do anything to save you. But if you can somehow convince Sir Vice, we may be able to use the Emperor's death to end this.
So basically, you want us to do whatever we can to get to Sir Vice?
Yes. If you go now, you should be able to find him in the throne hall.
Okay. We owe you one.
Oh.
What is it?
Where's Nico? I don't see him anywhere.
He decided to leave us.
What? Why would he do that?
I don't know. I guess he just didn't want to cause us any more trouble. I'm sure he had his reasons.
Haven't you...
No.
Anyway, we're short on time. Let's get this letter delivered.
He's the one most worried about Nico, you know. I wish he'd be more honest about it.
He's just at that difficult age in his life.
Lark.
Well, well, puppet of Imaginal. Did you come here to die?
I have a letter here from the head senator of the Republic that needs to be delivered to the Emperor.
I don't believe I've met you.
My name is Leslie Ferrati, and I am here on behalf of the head senator.
I suppose you're here to request a ceasefire. Another one of your divine revelations, no? I have no intention of siding with real or imaginal. Though if my father were still alive, things would be different. He really did choose the perfect time to die.
North Noirism has no relation to this request. The choice was made solely by the Senate.
Unfortunately, I know that the Republic Senate is under the rule of North Noirism. Even if you weren't lying, you'd still have an insider reporting back to the North Noirists right now.
We will not allow any intervention by either the North Noirists or Imaginal.
How can you say that? Aren't you the child of Issa who chose Imaginal's law?
Alf's a child of Issa too.
Alf?
He has traveled the world, singing the praises of Real's law. But I don't get it. Why are we forced to choose between two gods?
I don't care. I'm not interested. Save it for someone who is. I live by my own rules.
Your rules don't matter. If Alf presents Real's law to Issa, the world will be crystallized.
So do you think you can save the world with Imaginal's law, then?
I don't know. I don't know which side is the right one. Maybe both of us are wrong.
You don't know? Ha! Makes sense. You being a mindless puppet works better for them. Give me that letter! I'll get back to you regarding the ceasefire. Come to my office tomorrow.
Nice job, Lark.
You think so?
Well, yeah. Prince Vice accepted the letter, didn't he?
Compared to almost being put to death, I suppose we're making some progress.
Don't hold your breath. The way things are going, we'll probably be in a jail cell tomorrow.
So what should we do until then?
Let's go to Zamuel's school. They ought to have enough room for us.
Strange how Vice didn't seem too broken up over his father's death. Huh.
Yeah, you're right.